Hey friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to bring you guys this mirror windmill DIY using Dollar Tree products. I've had this idea in my head for a while and just haven't gotten around to it, so I'm so excited I did today. If you're new to my channel and stopping by for the first time, thank you so much for stopping by. I would love it if you become part of this crafty family if you love to craft on a budget. And for those of you returning, thank you so much for stopping by. So let's get into it. So I have two mirrors. I only end up using one because I ran out of time. I will be doing another one, but you just need a knife, painter's tape, some floral wire, these round mirrors from Dollar Tree, two placemats, a pencil, and a ruler, and then silver spray paint. So to start off, I just take my painter's tape and I'm going to just stick it in the mirror, and then around the sides, I kind of just get it in there really nicely to the mirror, and then that way when we go to spray paint, our mirror doesn't get ruined. So I just cut rip a few pieces and stick it in there, and then I take my knife and just cut away the excess. So I just run my knife along the inner part right by the mirror. You can see what I'm doing because it probably doesn't make much sense what I'm saying. And again, I didn't end up using the other one right at this moment, but I definitely am going to be making another one. So you guys could make one, you can make two, you can make 10. It's all up to you, but it was really fun and easy. So I'm just taking my ruler and marking out where I want the top of my windmill blades to be. I ended up cutting one too small at first, but I will leave a link in the, or not a link, I will leave the measurements in the description box for you. That way, if you like the size of my blades, then you can do yours the same. So I just cut them out, and here's where I show you that I cut one too small. So I redid it, and this size is much better. So basically, I just trace out my blade after I cut the first one out. That way I would have a template. So all in all, I made 8 blades, and I probably could have gotten 8 out of just one, but I had already cut the smaller one. But anyway, I grabbed 2 placemats just to be safe and ended up needing it anyway, so I would definitely grab 2. And if you want to do more, then grab more. So I just kind of played with the edges, but it didn't matter anyway because they ended up going flat. So here I am just marking the back of my mirror, kind of like you would cut a pizza. And then that way my blades would be perfectly spaced out. So I just took my ruler and drew those lines. So next I am just kind of figuring out where I want my blades. So I took my ruler and from the bottom I marked 1 inch. And then that way I knew exactly where the edge would stop. So here I'm just gluing it. I glued down one of the sides and on the other side, and then I glue a little bit on the edge and right down that line. Also, you want to make sure that the middle of your blade is right in the middle of that line. So I just continue around the whole back of the mirror, attaching all of my blades.
I want to be daring, baby, dance the night away. I let my head down if I want. Don't you just get tired chasing fame and being pretty all the time? Doesn't sound like fun. You can do better. Let me show you what a good time looks like. You can do better, so much better.
Next, I took my floral wire, and I did get the thicker floral wire. I just wanted to mention that. And I cut 8 strips. And I just held them up so that I had even strips. I did try to make this one big piece, but I couldn't get it straight enough, so I just reverted back to making individual pieces. So I just kind of bend them into a like rounder shape, and then I just take my hot glue on each end and I glue them down. And you can see what I'm doing here. In the end, it doesn't come out perfect. I don't think anything is ever perfect. I played with it for a long while trying to get them right, and there was no way it was gonna come out perfect. Maybe you could get it too, but I kind of lost patience after a while, and it come out pretty good, so I'm not complaining. So I then spray painted it with my hammered spray paint, and then I take my Elephant Waverly chalk paint and just dab. Now, in my previous videos, I have done this and I couldn't find a brush that I really liked, so I picked up these sponges from Walmart, I believe, and they come in like a 4 or 5 pack, and they're just the natural sponges, and I really, really like the way that it's coming out with these sponges. So I definitely recommend these. They're a few bucks, but you get a few in a pack, so I don't really mind. And I just take my elephant and I dab it randomly all over the whole piece. So before I started to paint the blades, I realized that I wanted to put my hanger on here. So I got this pack of bunch of hangers from Amazon. I'll link it down below. It's definitely a good deal. There's all different types and sizes, and so I definitely recommend this. But before I painted it, I definitely wanted to put my hanger, that way I didn't mess up my whole paint job. So I just glue that down, because the hanger that was on there was like on crooked, I don't know, but it definitely wouldn't have hung right, so I just put my own on there. So then I just continue with my elephant, dabbing all over the whole thing. And you guys, this part is addicting. I really enjoy doing this part. I could sit here all day and do this, but it really doesn't take very long. And then you go in with your white and you're basically doing the same exact thing, but just not as much as you do the gray. So if you go a little bit crazy like I did with the white, all you have to do is just go right back in with your elephant and tone down the brightness of that white color. And it's really easily fixable, so don't worry about it if you do go a little crazy on any of the colors, really. You can just go right back in with the gray and fix it. So I just dab my white around and I blend it. Not wiping, just dabbing. You don't want to wipe, you just want to dab, because if you wipe, it just smears and then you don't get that beautiful galvanized effect. So after I dab with my white, I go in with Truffle chalk paint. It's a brown color, and I focus on the ring around the mirror, the middle part, because I want that part to look like rust and I wanted that part to stand out. So I use my sponge for the middle part. I tried to use my sponge for the edges, but I didn't really like the way that it turned out. I wanted the edges to look like rust as well. So I just went in with a paintbrush and I just kind of focused on the edges, pulling inwards, going from the edge and pulling inwards, and I just did that randomly as well. So the middle part looks really good with your sponge and the truffle, but again, I would just use a brush for the blades.
You left me running on and on.
guys, so this is the best part, the moment of truth. So I have this weeder from my Cricut tools, but you can use a knife or anything you want, really. But I just use it to peel up the painter's tape, and it looks so good. I'm so glad that I did this DIY. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do that, so that way you're notified every single time I upload. Thank you guys so, so much for stopping by. If you enjoyed this video, please, please give me a big thumbs up. Those thumbs up really help my channel to grow. And until next time, bye.
I don't think we got enough time to sort out the fights, yeah. Sort out the lies. Oh, baby, yeah. I don't know. There was a part of me that knew that. And still I'm caught by surprise. Oh.